You want Instagram analytics that are free? Let me show you where to find them and how to use them. We'll take you through the whole process right now. What's up, busy people? Welcome to 5 Minute Social Media. If you've ever had figure out social media on your to-do list for your brand, and then it just keeps getting pushed down the list because you're overwhelmed, you don't know where to start, you're in the right place. We put out a new quick video every week to help you with a different piece of your digital marketing strategy. So if that's something you need, please take a second and go ahead and hit subscribe now. In fact, yet another reason to subscribe, when I wrote the notes for this video about a week ago, I had everything all ready to go. This morning I went to film and Instagram has totally changed the way the analytics look. So new stuff is coming out all the time. My name is Jerry Potter. Yes, it rhymes with the boy wizard. And by the end of this video, you're going to not only know how to look at your Instagram analytics, but also how to use those numbers to help you grow your account. Same tactics that I use for all of my agency and private clients as well. So just like any platform you're trying to grow, the best strategy is to look at the things that are working and then do more of those. And this applies to Instagram, YouTube, dieting. You know, if you start eating something that makes you feel good, eat more of it. Actually, dieting might be a terrible example because ice cream makes me feel amazing. And I probably shouldn't eat any more of that. So the old way of tracking how your posts were doing on Instagram was really time consuming if you're going to do it right. You're going to sit down, open a spreadsheet, put in how each post did, look for patterns, things like that. Now Instagram provides you with free analytics to help grow your account. Now, first step, you have to convert your Instagram profile to a business profile if you haven't done that yet. The good news is it's free, takes about 60 seconds to do, and I've got a video that I'll put the link up right here or down in the description if you want to watch that and convert first. Not sure yet? Let me show you what Instagram analytics offers for a business profile, and then you can decide. So once you have a business profile on Instagram, go ahead and let me grab my phone here, open up Instagram. And you're going to click these lines here up at the top of the screen. They look kind of like the how many bars do I have cell phone signal. But click on those. That'll take you to the analytics for Instagram or insights, which is a little bit less nerdy. All right, the first thing that'll come up is it'll show you what you've had happen in the last 7 days. Your actions includes people who have visited your profile, people who have clicked on your website link, and then also people who have maybe clicked on a phone number, directions, email, anything they've clicked on your profile. So as you can see, I've had 24 of those in the last week. That does not include likes and comments. Down below that, under discovery, you'll see your reach and your impressions. So the reach is the number of unique people that you reached with your profile in the last 7 days. Impressions is the number of time your posts were seen. So let's say you put something up and I saw it 5 times. That would mean that reach, one person saw it, but for impressions, it would count as 5. So that means people are seeing your content over and over again. It could be intentionally, it could be because the algorithm is favoring it because it's good content, so they're showing it more and more. If you ever forget any of that, down here at the bottom of the screen, you see a little thing that says, what do these mean? You can click on that, and it's a little cheat sheet glossary for when you're looking at these. These blue bars across the middle show you the reach from each of the different days. Now, considering I post on Sundays, Mondays, and Thursdays, no surprise that those are the biggest days. Now, if we click on content, that's going to show specifically how each piece of content performed. So across the top, you'll see your posts, and it'll show you how much engagement you got. So my top post last week got 98, which is a combination of likes and comments. If you don't remember what that post was, you can click on it and it'll pull it right up. You want to see more about your post, you can click see more and it'll bring up all of them. So by default, this is showing me everything I've posted in the last year sorted by impressions. Now, if you want to change that, click on any of the blue letters. You can actually go in and you can say, okay, I want to see just how my videos did. Actually, let's do photos because I don't have that many videos. And based on likes for the last 3 months, hit apply, resorts it. Here you go. These are my top photos based on likes from the past 3 months. So you can really get in and see what your content is doing. A couple of strategies for you to consider for your brand. If you are trying to get more people to follow you, well, that involves getting a profile visit. So I might go in and say, okay, in the last year, show me the top post by profile visits. So I can see, obviously, each post itself is not leading to a whole lot, but I can see that photos of people tend to bring a lot more people to look at my profile and decide whether or not they want to follow me. If your goal is to get a lot of engagement, a lot of comments, then you might go in and say, okay, show me, sorted by, number of comments I got. So now I can see which videos or photos got the most comments, and then I want to create more of that content if my goal is to get more comments. Now, under content, below posts, you'll see your stories. It's going to show you your stories there from the last 24 hours. I've only posted one thing, obviously. Shows you how many people have seen it. If you click See More, it'll actually show you all of your stories from the past couple of weeks. So you can then see how many impressions each one got. I like to look at these based on impressions because if people watched it more than once, that's usually a good indication. You can also click on the blue words and adjust these by all kinds of different things you want to look at. Impressions and reach, we've already talked about. Taps forward means that somebody skipped ahead before that particular clip was over. Sometimes, though, that just means they looked at the picture and read it and moved on. Taps back means they went back to watch something again because they missed it. Exits means they exited out of Instagram stories altogether. Might be a bad sign, but down here, swipes away, that means that they were done with your story, but they wanted to keep watching other people's stories. So anything that has a lot of those, you probably want to do less of or fix the storyline or whatever it might be. And then replies means they actually reply to your story, which is obviously a good sign if you got engagement, somebody reacted to it. It's not like Facebook where people reply to everything you post. It's a little tougher on Instagram stories. And down at the bottom, you see promotions. If you've ever paid to boost any of your Instagram posts, that's where that's gonna show up. And the third tab back at the top is, of course, audience. This is fantastic. You can really get a good idea of who's following you and find out if your brand is reaching the right people. Or you might be surprised to find out that people like your brand that you didn't think were going to. So I can see here first how many followers I have. I've lost 2 in the last 7 days. And you use hashtags a lot like I do. The followers go up and down because people follow and then unfollow with their Instagram bots. If you've seen your followers go up and down, that's the reason it's happening. People were following you, hoping you'll follow them back. They aren't going to keep following you, though, because they want to keep following other people. You can see my gender breakdown. It's 39% men, 61% women. Down below here, you can see all the age breakdowns. You can also click on men or women if you want to see if they're different. Down here, top cities, no surprise. Top cities are cities that I live in or have lived in. You can also see by countries. I'm obviously doing really well in Nigeria. and then down here, this is the most important part of this audience data, and if you take one thing from this video, this is what I want you to grab. Down here, it shows you when your people are most active on Instagram. That means they're signed in, they're looking at posts, and things like that. The first hour that you put up an Instagram post is crucial, because that's when Instagram is showing it to people and testing it. If you have your post go up and nobody likes it or comments on it in the first hour, they're not going to keep showing it to as many people. They'll still show it to some, but that's really when the algorithm decides, is this good content or is it eh content? By the way, eh content, not an official Facebook term. That's a me term. So you can go through and you can see, like if I click on days, I can see which days my audience is most active. And then I can decide to post on those particular days. I can also then look per day. So let's say I say, okay, I want to post on, looks like Wednesdays are good. So I'll go over to hours and I scroll through to Wednesdays. And I see, okay, oh, they are most active around 6 o'clock. So that's when I'm gonna plan to schedule my post. Now, every account and every audience is different. This is just a starting point. You can experiment beyond that and figure out when your posts do the best. But if you have no idea when to start, use these analytics and start that way. Now, another school of thought is that at those popular times, that's when everybody else is posting too. So you may, like I said, experiment and find that another time works for you. But if you just have no idea where to start, start by posting when your people are online. So when you're looking at your demographic information, let's say that you are an online Etsy shop, you sell jewelry for women. 99% of your buyers are women, 90%, whatever. And 45% of your followers and people that engage with you are men. Well, you might be a little off. Yes, the men could be shopping for their women, or the men could be looking at photos of women modeling your jewelry. I don't know. Creepy, right? But that's just something to think about. Look at your analytics, see if they're on point or not, and if they're not, you might want to change what you're posting. So maybe once a week, you go into your analytics, you'll just kind of look and see how things are doing. But you can also, at any time, you're just scrolling through your own feed, you see a post, click View Insights right there under the picture, and it'll specifically bring up the numbers for you right there. So you can see exactly what happened, how many people visited your profile, how many people saw this post that weren't following you. Different things like that. I know this video has gone on for a bit, but two more quick things that I think are really important. One, if your account is medium to small, I mean, mine is medium at best, and the numbers don't look really big, don't be discouraged like that. Every account that has 10,000 followers started with 0, and you can be in the same boat. With 10,000, not 0. And two, if you do start using your analytics and looking at things and changing things, and you don't see immediate results, don't panic, okay? Sometimes it takes 2 to 3 months for your strategy. So if you're confident in it, Stick with it. Don't change strategies like my wife changes shoes. No, not talking about you. Stick with it. You'll be just fine. All right, are you using Instagram for your business? I'd love to see what you're doing. I'm sure others in our community would as well. So leave your link down in the comments. You got a question, you can leave that there as well. Or join our private Facebook group. Just go to Facebook and search for 5 Minute Social Media, or I've got the link down in the description as well. If you made it this far, I assume you got something out of this video, so please give it a like and hit subscribe so you're notified next time a new video comes out. You wanna hit that bell. And you'll be all set. You're not only supporting me, but also my two tiny superheroes at home. Thank you for watching 5 Minute Social Media.